Thanks for clicking. Hope you stay. We recently just purchased our first queen ant. We were a bit concerned if they'd make it safe and well in the mail, but they did. And they had packed them quite well. The company is UK-based. If you are in that country, you can have a look on their store. They do have quite a few different types of ants and other insects. Now, if you have watched our other videos, and I hope you have, you'll know we built the nest system from Waikushi for these ants. We will be putting these ants into that nest system. We thought these type of ants, the Asian carpenter ants from South Asia, would be ideal for us. Being beginners, they don't hibernate. They grow to be large ants, have workers of many different sizes and grow fast, so should be amazing to look at year round. The queen can live to around 25 years and have several queens per nest. They do need a bit of heat, so we put a heat pad under their nest since we live in a cooler climate, even in the summer. That's Scotland for you. You can see the queen here being fed by one of her workers, who has just visited the outworld and brought back something nice and sweet, no doubt a bit of melon. This is the Waikushi nest system. It has a little test tube for water to help with humidity. Also, a place underneath where you connect your test tube where your ants have their nest. We weren't sure if the test tube was the same size as the one that came with the kit, so we were checking the size here. It simply just clicks in, then the ants are free to use the outworld section, the top bit. Ants communicate primarily through the use of pheromones, which are chemical signals that convey information to other members of their colony. Each pheromone has a specific meaning, and ants have a highly developed sense of smell that allows them to detect and interpret these signals. Here are some of the ways in which ants use pheromones to communicate. When they are foraging and find a food source, it leaves a pheromone trail leading back to the nest. Amazing! Or if an ant discovers a large food item that it cannot carry back to the nest on its own, it releases a recruitment pheromone to call other ants for help. Okay, I want a pheromone to make him wash up the dishes. This little guy. He's having a feast on this bit of cookie. They love the sugar, but also require protein. So we also put in a bit of egg to give them a more balanced diet. They require a lot of protein to help build their colony, and sugar, of course, for energy. Oh, a little bit of pheromone communication going on there. He's focused on getting some of that watermelon sugar to take back to his nest. That is just pure sugar and energy. He's filled his tank and taking it back to his queen. So loyal. Man on a mission. I think she is pleased about what her worker ant brought back for her. This is another type of communication going on here. You can see tactile signals touching each other and using vibrations. These methods help them exchange information and coordinate their activities within the colony. She's probably going to want more of that by the looks. Thank you. can't tell here if she's getting more food from this other ant or if she's giving. You can see that other worker ant in the background just going about his tasks, taking care of the eggs. That's probably his one job. He best not mess that up. You know, ants can lift between 10 to 50 times their own body weight. This guy has got quite the task ahead of him. When we got these ants, we had 5 workers, with eggs. Unfortunately, due to stress and lack of heat, we suspect, the queen did eat all of her eggs. We did notice recently that she has started laying eggs again, so hopefully in 11 or so weeks we will see some baby workers. Thank you,